Hello everyone, and welcome to my first Halloween video ever here on YouTube. I'm very excited to bring you my recreation of Michelle Phan's zombie Audrey Hepburn makeup tutorial. I fell in love with the idea, and now I'm in love with the results. So, let's begin. I'm going to be applying a primer because when we buff in the foundation, I want it to look as if it's my actual skin color. I'm using a very, very pale foundation, but if you are paler than I am, then feel free to mix a whiten with your normal color. This foundation that's extremely pale, although I do understand some people are actually the skin tone, it sort of comes off more ashy on mine because I have such a strong yellow undertone. So this really cool pale foundation is going to make me look pretty dead. I'm just going to buff this in with a Real Techniques buffing brush, just really working it into the skin because although we're a zombie, we are still Audrey Hepburn and she is completely flawless. So remember to bring that foundation all the way down your neck, your ears, your shoulders, any skin that's going to be exposed. Now, Audrey wears long gloves, so I didn't feel the need to bring it all the way down my arms, but I'm going to sort of make it look more flawless with a beauty blender just so everything looks really nice and almost ceramic. Just make your skin look really nice and flawless and also extremely pale. Set it with some powder to make it matte because zombies don't have any natural oils coming through because they're dead, so yeah. And now I'm going to move on to Audrey Hepburn's eyebrows. I'm going to use a pomade. This is the Anastasia one. Use any brow product you would like. I just thought it'd be easier to use something that was extremely pigmented like this one. And I'm going to go for that straight brow. Although in Breakfast at Tiffany's, Audrey didn't have such strong brows as she did in the 50s, I still wanted to give her the iconic brow that she was known for. So I'm going in to the outer half of the brows first before moving in towards the front like I usually do, but making sure to make sure the eyebrows are very straight and even. Also put some concealer underneath because I messed up a couple times. The Naked Basics palette with Walk of Shame, and I'm going to use as a base shadow all over the lid to block out any warmth coming through from my eyes because this is a very pink toned cool shadow, as you can tell. And then I'm going to go in with Naked 2, and I'm sort of going to angle this up towards my brow to give my eyes a little more of a droopy dead appearance. And this eyeshadow is very cool toned, as you can see. It was a gray browny shade, so we don't want any type of warm shadow on the eyes. Now moving on to the famous liner, I am making it the same thickness all the way across the lash line and up to the wing. You want to just make it a little kitten wing, nothing too crazy. Using these eyelashes from Allure, I don't stay in frame because I'm a horrible person, but as you can see, they're really nice and fluttery. So then I'm going to apply some mascara, tight line my eyes to make sure there is no skin peeking through. And I'm also going to put mascara on the lower lashes. And now for the contour, I'm going to take that brown shadow you see there, it's a very cool tone shadow, and I'm going to follow the natural cheekbone on my face, sort of bringing it downwards into that skeletal, sunken in appearance because we are decaying. And then I'm going to also contour my nose, and this is a little more of like a glam step, but I think it looks really nice at the end. And now I'm going to start sinking in my under eyes, and I'm using the same brown shadow, and for this entire look, the zombie portion, I begin with this brown shadow before adding any type of bruising or other coloring to the face. So as you can see, I'm taking that BH palette there, mixing together the purples, the reds, the browns, just to give it a very bruised appearance around my eyes. I'm gonna just blend this all under the eyes, through the crease, make it so that it's like an all-over reddish brown sort of gross purpley appearance. It's just to have the base there for the veins that I'm going to be drawing in now. I also deepened the crease a little bit with some brown just to make it all look a little more sunken in. So as you can see, I'm taking a fine liner brush with a teal shadow, also from the BH Cosmetics brush, and I'm really getting in there and like penciling and detailing in those veins. You just want to have a very light hand. As you can see, I'm holding the brush from the end just so I don't have too much pressure on it, and just sort of drag the brush down in the natural shape of a vein. And sort of like you've been dead for a while. And yeah, really cute. I'm going to continue contouring around the forehead and just skip the actual temple part and contour above that, because remember, this is still pretty glam. You're a glam zombie. I'm gonna draw some more veins onto the face. Just continue doing that. And now for the fun of liquid latex. Now, use a brush that you are not gonna miss. A paintbrush usually is what I would like to use. I've planned out where I want the wounds to be, so I've already thought of how I'm gonna have two on my cheek there, one on my forehead, one on my neck, and then on my lips. So I am just sort of mapping out where I'm going to have the ripped flesh. Super cute. And don't get it in your hair like I did. But as you can see, I am just splacking it on there. I don't know how else to say it. Make sure that you have a decent amount of latex on there so that you have a decent amount to rip. Now, the one on my neck was a little more difficult because it got caught on some of my baby hairs, so please be careful with that. And now, while waiting for that to dry, I'm going to go ahead and work on the lips. This is a very nice lip color from Buxom that I think matches the lip color shade in the movie very well. So I'm going to start off with the normal lip color, a nice peachy pink color. And then I'm going to go in with a brown lip liner and start to outline the lips and make them look more dead. And I just like to do this in steps. I don't want to do everything at once. So I am just drawing the outline of the decaying part of my lip, making sure not to be neat at all. And then I'm gonna apply some liquid latex on the bottom and the top part of my lip, because I'm just gonna make it as it feels like one big scar. And then applying that purpley brown shade that I had just left over on the brush into the center of my lip to make them look pretty dead. And now, taking a tweezer, I am very gently ripping the liquid latex. As you can see, I already did the one on my forehead, but I'm gonna show you here how I shade it. So taking that brown shade, the Naked 2 color, I'm just going to shade around the part of the liquid latex to make it seem as if that's the actual decaying part of my skin. And then I'm gonna mix those purple and red and brown shades again, just to make it look a little more realistic and veiny and bruised. Taking a black gel liner, I'm going into the inside of the hole with that to make it look as if, you know, there's nothing there. I'm pretty dead. And then buffing that out to make it look a little more realistic and just adding more color as I see need be. And now going in with the blood. Oh, so gross. When I first put it on, I was really confused. Like, wow, this looks like actual blood. But take another paintbrush that you're not gonna miss and make sure to make it look cute, just like that. And then I'm just going to show you how I did the other cool scars. You can see I already did the lip scars and wounds and whatnot, but the huge gash on the side of my cheek, I just wanted to show you how I technically did that. So I just got some tweezers, pulled the end of a latex strip down until it had a fine point at the end. I wanted to look if it was an actual wound. Then I'm going to do two of those on the cheeks on top of the latex, and then do the same shading as before. I always start with the brown because it makes it look a lot more realistic and as if you are actually decaying. Then I'm taking the purple and the reds again just to make it look more bruised, taking the black gel liner afterwards, and then the blood. Why do I look so happy? Is it me applying fake blood to my face? I don't know. And then I also put some around my mouth because you have been eating brains and people and everything and whatnot, so. And then I went ahead and did the neck wound for you guys there, and this is the completed look. I really, really enjoy doing these type of gory looks. Love how it came out. If you try out this look, please tag me on Instagram or Twitter. But other than that, I hope you guys have a great day and a wonderful Halloween. Bye.